So again, now we rebuild the compiler. You'll notice there's some different configuration to do at the start this time because we moved on a stage. So this is all one command because that first line's got a backslash on it. So we'll copy all of that and paste it all in. And then once again we've got a for do loop. So all of that gets copied and pasted in there. Again, you can see the same copy commands have been run. Another case command for 64-bit. Again, if you ran that on 32-bit, it wouldn't matter, it just wouldn't do anything. So there's no harm in doing it if you're not sure. And now these other packages we need to install. These actually get compiled and installed in their own right in the final installation. But for our purposes in the temporary tools section, it's sufficient just to extract them as if they were part of GCC. So this little line here, again, it's a single command. As it says, it fixes a problem with the newer glibc. So now I can move on to creating the build directory, changing into it, and running the configure command. And now we're going to make, and you'll notice the previous compile took 6 minutes or so. This one will take a little bit longer as we recompile each package. They take longer and longer because either more features are being enabled or there are more packages supplying features to the packages we're building, so they'll take longer and longer each time. Right, so that's complete. It's taken about 2 minutes longer. Let's say there's probably more to compile. So we can now install it. And this command creates a link to CC for compatibility. And once again, we're just going to check the basic functionality of the compiler and C library and bin utils, which are collectively known as the toolchain. Also includes the Linux headers. So that's just compiled a little mini C program we created with the first command. And once again, just double check this output. Tools lib 64 LD Linux x86-64.0.2, so that's okay. So you don't need to really remove these as separate commands because we're going to be deleting the build directory. Now that we've completed this part, so and we can, that's the tool chain done now really for this section. We're just going to be moving on to some smaller support packages for the rest of the temporary LFS system.